Welcome back to Shop Talk. I'm Ria Tanjuatco-Trillo, and still with us is Sabrina Artadi of Sabrina's Kitchen, which, as you know, airs on the Lifestyle Channel, and they will be back come January, and you'll be on TFC as well.
Yes, yes. Wonderful. I'm very excited about that. Okay. And see how, you know, the Filipinos abroad will take to the show.
I'm sure they're gonna love it. And here on Shop Talk, which is actually a great place for you while your show's on holiday,
yes,
you're gonna teach us the third dish for today, which is like a cream cheese salmon appetizer.
Yes, this is basically all cream cheese based because it's available, it's healthy for you, and it's actually quite yummy when you mix some different flavors in it as well.
All right.
So our third and last dish is basically cream cheese again. Mm-hmm. Then I'm going to put some yogurt over it sort of make it just a wee bit lighter. So you just have to pour your yogurt on.
Yum.
Same principle. Just cover up the cheese.
All right.
And then
make the magic happen.
Ta-da! Smell that.
So smoked salmon.
Yes, smoked salmon.
It actually kind of smells like a vacation. It smells like a holiday, right?
Isn't that great? And again, super healthy. You know, the holidays, people get sick because it's halal, lechon, hamon. Yeah. Let's try to, you know, do our guests and family a favor and give them something healthy. Not quite a diet, no punishment, but yummy, healthy food as well.
Okay, I'm all for that.
So here we go with our cream cheese and yogurt. And then we're just going to sprinkle this.
All right, so you chopped that up, and then you sort of like spiced it. What is that? What did you?
Just black pepper.
Black pepper.
Just some black pepper in there.
Some freshly cracked black pepper.
Yes, so this is really Christmas on a dish. I mean, it's so pretty. All you need is a little bow, and it looks like a gift.
Actually, that is true.
Very beautiful.
All that salmon on there. Yum. I love smoked salmon. Any time of year, actually. Mm. That'll do just fine.
So you kind of use the yogurt as your glue. Right?
Okay, that's what's going to make it all stick.
Yeah, there you go. And then...
Okay. And we're not done yet.
We're not done.
All right. More beautiful colors to add on the dish.
Go. I'm going to make this woman a cook yet.
Yeah, okay, nothing is impossible. Nothing is impossible. Okay, so how do you want me to arrange it?
Just
on the side.
Stick it. Yeah.
Okay, all right.
So you've got celery sticks.
All right.
You've got some carrot sticks.
All right. Put a celery here.
Very healthy, very yummy flavors.
Okay.
Celery's got a very distinct flavor. I have yet to find a description for it, but it's just beautiful and crunchy. The carrot as well, fabulous. And then I'm going to sprinkle some dill.
Oh, I can smell that from here. And again, that's just from your garden.
Yes, my yaya's a whiz.
Okay.
She grows all this.
Oh, so that looks amazing now.
Look at that. And I tell you, it's absolutely divine. Now, did I do this in 2-3 minutes? You saw
Probably
it.
Probably less.
So if you're running late, it's traffic, and you are making the hors d'oeuvres because it's fun, you got to do it, you can get that.
I love it.
Recipe on time, on the table for your guests, and looking glamorous and fabulous too.
Yes.
That's important.
That's true. Because sometimes you have like a fabulous food and a really harassed hostess, or a gorgeous hostess, and then the food's like, so-so.
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to try with the carrot.
Okay.
And then I'm going to try with the celery. So I'm dipping in there.
Okay.
Okay. I need to get my salmon. Okay. Here we go.
Sound effects. There's no sound effects.
Where's my sound effects from my studio, guys? Oh, there you go. And you know, it's good, and I can like taste that it's healthy.
Yes, yes. So you taste the salmon, you taste the dill, right? And then, of course, the yogurt and the cheese all coming together. A little more black pepper if you want, but it is a gorgeous, gorgeous dish.
I have to say, this is my favorite of the three we've done.
I'm sure.
Yeah, this works. Okay, now I'm going to try with the
celery. With the celery.
All right. Oops. Okay. Here we go.
How easy to feed you all. I like that.
Yeah. We're pretty easy to please bunch around here in Shop Talk.
Well, it's really about that. Like I say, when you entertain, always be relaxed. Because if you are a nervous host, you pass that on to your guests.
And your food.
Yes, and your food as well. So I really don't know how these shows are with all this pressure and sweating. And I don't know, I think I would fail miserably in one of those.
Yeah, you would not enjoy Christmas, right?
No, we really have to be relaxed. And the whole point of being in the kitchen is therapy. and you know, enjoying the simple joys in life, exchanging comments about how the food tastes or combining this with that, bonding with kids. This is what Sabrina's Kitchen is trying to, you know, send a message to,
right,
people.
And that's why I think you're gaining more and more followers with every season.
Very kind. Right. Everybody's been so kind. I've had such wonderful stories from single moms and moms who have so much to do in driving their kids to school and rushing back and cooking. But one of my favorites is that it's made cooking a joy.
And not a chore.
Yeah. So I'm grateful. Thank you so much, friends. Please keep on sending me those wonderful messages. And I'm grateful for your support. And Sabrina's Kitchen is not just about the food. There's so many things that are created within the kitchen with creativity and food and flavors flying around. We have clothes.
That's true.
Yeah, I'm wearing one of my creations.
And wouldn't you know it, we have some more here behind us. Okay, so tell us about this. While I'm opening this up, tell us about
what you're wearing. Well, basically, it's our beautiful hoosie. So when people ask me what I'm wearing, literally, I say I'm wearing a banana because it's our banana fiber.
Right.
And we should be very proud. I think in the world, we have one of the most beautiful silks. This is a silk. And it's malleable, and my silk, we call this the Sabrina silk, is washable. So how practical is that?
Okay.
Great for traveling as well.
And you paint this yourself?
I love it. And I get attached to each piece. So usually they're ordered and they're sold, but I do get attached.
These are gorgeous.
Okay. Thank you so much.
So look, there's more colors to choose from. This is a nice green one. Very festive as well.
Very happy and bright colors.
Like you're wearing a mini dress under that.
Yeah, just a chemise.
Okay.
Just a chemise.
Or you can do the legging thing.
Yes, you can do leggings if you want to hide stuff under there.
Right.
You can also do jeans if you want to casualize it.
So it's really, really versatile.
It's very, very versatile.
It depends just like what kind of mood you're in or what event you're attending.
Yeah, and we're also doing them in men's barongs. So we have our usual barongs, but I find that a lot of the foreigners love the fabric and want to wear it, but somehow can't get past that, you know, the beige barong with the embroidery.
Right, right.
So when it comes out sort of batikish and patterns like this, I have jungle patterns and things. They're sort of, I could so wear that. So it's getting the foreigner, the rest of the world, to now wear our fabric.
And how do you wash this? Just hand wash, cold
water? You have a little bit of downy or something like that in a cap. Put that in a pail and you just stick this in and squeeze it and hang. You don't scrub.
Okay.
So you just squeeze it down so that the water runs
out. Yeah.
Yeah, and then hang it.
And that's it.
Yeah, and then you can iron it. But then again, it's a pretty, it's gusut mayaman as well, as they call it, right? So it's pretty just as is.
Even with a slight crinkle.
Crinkle, which is why it travels very, very well.
Okay, and of course, if you're going to wear one of these, you might